This evening with Ida Ross Freeman,
right,
member of the Canton City School District Board of Education,
correct,
who is here this evening at the Stark Community Foundation candidates event. She's a candidate for State Board of Education, District 8, as I understand. Is that correct?
That's correct.
When let's talk a little bit about your time on the Canton City School Board. How long you been a member of the board?
I've been on the local board 3 years.
3 years?
A little over 3 years.
What's your experience been?
That they made policy in Columbus, and we implement it, whether we like it or not.
Do you like it?
Most of it.
And most of it?
Yes.
Okay.
I think it's for the good of the children, the students.
Okay. Well, you've had a chance to assess the quality of the Canton City schools. What's your assessment?
I think good things are happening in Canton. I mean, we're venturing into new horizons with our brighter tomorrow. I think it's great.
How's the funding?
To my knowledge, it's right on target.
Okay, so everything's looking pretty good in the Canton City School District.
That's right. And next year, when we have these conferences, I'm going to encourage our superintendent to participate by being a presenter, because then we will have data to prove that ours is a success story.
And your superintendent is?
Adrian Allison.
And has he been hired during your term on the board?
Yes, he was.
Okay, and you have a positive assessment of the hire?
Yes, yes.
And State Board of Education, when did you come up with the idea of running for State Board of Education?
When I would go down to the State Board meetings, and I saw how it was, and I thought, we need a voice from the community on that board to talk about what we need in our communities, especially dealing with the urban children and the rural children. It's like they forget us.
Okay, so it's just the suburban kids that they look after.
I didn't say that. You said that.
I said it. Are you going to argue with me?
No, I didn't say that.
Okay, and so now, District 8, what's the area that it covers?
It covers Athens, Belmont, Carroll, Columbiana, Harrison, Jefferson, Mahoney, Meigs, Monroe, Noble, part of Stark, and part of Benton, Washington.
I see. And who's the current board member for District 8? You know?
Debbie. Debbie Kane.
Debbie Kane, and she's not running for re-election.
She's term limit.
Term limited out, I
right,
see.
Right, right.
I think she's running for state representative
right,
in the 50th House District.
Okay. Right, right.
Anybody else announced for the position?
Yeah.
Oh, there are. So you have more than one opponent?
It's two other opponents.
Two other opponents.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
All right. Anything, any message that you want to give the voters out there to look into the Stark County Political Report for information about candidates?
It's good you asked me that. I just came from a legislative breakfast. And at that breakfast was a legislator representative who is the driving force behind the repeal of the Common Core standards. And he was really talking. I'm listening and I'm thinking, that's why I didn't like it, because it was for one group of kids, not all kids.
I see, the suburban kids.
I didn't say that.
Well, I did.
I didn't say that.
You're not arguing with me.
I didn't say that. I don't know if they tested it on the urban kids, the suburban kids.
Uh-huh.
This was not a test curriculum.
Uh-huh.
It wasn't tested out, so we could have data to say this is a good program.
So you're undecided on Common Core, is that right?
Well, it's a good concept, but I don't know. It's a good concept, but the testing, you know, all the children want to be able to pass this test that they, you know, eventually come up with.
You think there's too much testing in our schools?
Well, I was brought up, when I went to school, we had testing. Okay, but when my children went to school here in Ohio, they had no testing, and I was really upset about that, because how am I to know they qualify to graduate from high school.
I see. Okay.
It's qualification to show that you did something to qualify to graduate from high school.
Anything else that you want to share with the viewing public?
I think we need to implement early language classes, like pre-K and kindergarten and first grade, teaching different languages.
Okay. Anything else?
No.
Okay. Well,
thank you so much.
Thank you very much.
All right.